So for 20 years now, I'm a big fan of the MacBook Pros. In the beginning, they weren't called MacBook Pro, but for my pro audio activities, I used the Mac laptop. But 2 years ago, I switched to this Mac Mini because I didn't like the MacBook Pro that much anymore. I had problems with it, not only the keyboard, but also with the screen, and my sessions weren't running great anymore. So it was not reliable enough for me. But now there's a new MacBook Pro, the MacBook Pro 16-inch from 2019, and it has a lot of good features. Maybe I am switching to the MacBook Pro again. So here's why. First of all, the screen. It's a gorgeous screen. It's 16-inch, although the MacBook is still like the same size. So they crammed a 16-inch screen in this. Well, it's a little bit bigger than the last one, the 15-inch MacBook Pro. The resolution is a bit of an odd kind of thing because it's 3072 by 1920. So that's no HD, that's not Ultra HD, it's not 4K. But video looks great. It has a luminance of 500 nits. The color standard they're using is the color standard P3, I think. It's the Apple standard for RGB. Worked great for video, but what I like the most is that you can change the refresh rate. So from 48 Hertz to 50 Hertz to 60 Hertz, depending on the frame rate you used for recording, to have a very good response on your screen. And that's a tremendous thing. So standard for this MacBook Pro, there is 16 gigabytes of RAM, and I don't think that's enough for working with video or with audio. I think you need at least 32 gigabytes, and that's about 500 euros extra. 64 gigabytes is also an option, but that's 1000 euro extra, but you got a beast of a computer then. The processor I have in this one is the biggest one. That's the 2.3 8 core i9 9th generation Intel processor. It's a beast of a processor, but I think it's a lot of money for a very hot processor also. So if you start with the 2.6 gigahertz i7, that's a 6-core one, you're better off performance-wise. It's a very good one, and it's not so expensive. I chose for a 512 gigabytes SSD. Lower is not even possible, and 512 is enough for me. All my projects are on separate hard drives and external drives with Thunderbolt 3, so that's fast enough. But if you really need more storage, you can chop it up to 8 terabytes. That will set you back 3000 euros. So there's a separate graphic card in here, a graphic chip. It's the AMD Radeon 5300M. If you want to have a little better graphic chip, let's say the 5500M with 8 gigabytes of RAM, that's also possible. That's about 200 euros extra. And I would suggest you do that, because for video it's almost a must, but also for audio, when you're using with a lot of, you know, plugins with graphic analyzers, that takes up a lot of your graphic power, and you will start to notice that in your audio if you don't have a very good graphics chips in there. So a lot has been said about this new keyboard. Well, especially because the last keyboard of the MacBook Pro was a disaster. Keys were not working, made a lot of noise, and especially for me who wants to do some typing in the evening when my wife tries to sleep. This one doesn't have that problem anymore. This is really quiet. The tactile feel is perfect. There are a couple of millimeters on top of the frame, and also the space between the keys is very good. Okay, so I think I like this even more than my standalone Bluetooth keyboard. So normally I wouldn't mention anything of the audio in the MacBook itself, because in the studio you're using an external audio interface with big speakers like this here. But this is a different kind of thing, because the audio actually sound really good. They use 6 speakers in here, 2 very big woofers underneath the keyboard, but also the mic is really good. There is actually 3 mics over here. It's an array of mics, and they use something like noise cancelling that will eliminate all the reflections in the room. So actually what you're hearing now is me talking
me recording this actually, and it sounds very nice for overdubs, but also if you want to sing and use Logic, it's very usable, it's very direct, and well, it's a nice extra. And also these mics are working when you're using the front-facing camera and you're doing a chat via FaceTime. But the camera is not so done well. It's a 720p camera, so it's not even full HD. It's not even a 4K camera as on your iPhone, and it's very noisy. Okay, so it's a bit of a downfall. Together with no Wi-Fi 6 on this MacBook Pro, Wi-Fi 6 is the new fast standard, also on your iPhone, not on this MacBook Pro, but these are the only two small issues I could find. For the rest, it's a perfect laptop.
So every 3 years I am switching my Mac. So it's time, almost time for a new Mac Mini. But I could also go for this 16-inch MacBook Pro. So if I have the same configuration, this will be around 2200 euros and this will be around 3300 euros. But for this 1100 euros, I get a gorgeous screen, 16-inch. I get a very good keyboard, a touchpad, nice speakers, a very good microphone, a touch bar, which I'm using more and more, but also I'm getting a graphics card, and I need a separate graphic card for this one, a GPU, if I really want to do heavy stuff on it. So that's 1100 euros for 6 or 7 things I don't have in this one, and they are really good. I think it's a made decision. But okay, this is the MacBook Pro 16-inch.